parsement. The first is the 1 upon 1 plus x as it is into integration of dx over x minus sine ddx of 1 plus x whole power minus 1. This can be taken, 1 plus x can be taken the numerator into integration of e raised power x into dx. Okay, this value minus sign, this we are keeping as it is, not integrating, 1 plus x whole square into dx. Alright, so this is question number 15 we are doing. Now let me take this here. So finally, we have obtained this question. It is nothing but 1 upon 1 plus x into dx. This is minus sign, this we are writing here. So differentiation of 1 plus x minus 1 power is minus will come here plus power will be minus 1 minus 1, that means minus 2. It will be sign of integration, it is plus sign. Okay, and it is 1 plus x whole power minus 2 into e raised power s into dx. Integration of ex is dx. So this is minus sign. This we have not integrated upon 1 plus x whole square into dx. Okay, so this function is integration. These are the same thing. And let me write here 1 plus x e raised power x into multiplication plus. It's nothing but 1 upon 1 plus x whole square dx into dx minus sign dx upon 1 plus x whole square into dx cancel out. These two are cancelled out. Final answer is this one plus constant of integration. Let me change it. The final answer is 1 upon 1 plus x into e raised power x plus constant of integration. This is the final answer here. These two are same, constant of negative sign plus sign. Both are opposite to each other. Okay, so they are cancelled out. This is how we have to solve question number 15. These were of the same type. Let me take now question number 16. Now question number 16, what does it say? Now question number 16, that is question number 12th question right there. Okay, now let me take 16th question. Okay, this is there. Question number 16th, what is that? Now the integration is x square into sine square x into dx. Alright. And let's talk about sine square x is what? Since okay, so cos 2x cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus 2 sine square theta. This formula is there. Therefore, 2 sine square theta equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta. Or sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2. Okay, now let me substitute this type of value here. Finally, it will be x square into within bracket 1 minus cos 2x upon 2 into dx. Separating them, this is 1 upon 2. The sign of integration x square into dx minus sign 1 upon 2 is sign of integration x square into cos 2x into dx. It to be integrated by using bypass method. Simple integration. Only we have 1 upon x into x cube upon 3 minus sign. Now, in this, let me take common 1 upon 2. And x square is taken as first function, second function, using bypass method. So, using bypass method, we get this. I am writing here. It will be x square as it is integration of cos plus into dx. Okay, minus sign ddx of x square into integration of cos 2x into dx whole dx. It is nothing but x cube upon 6 minus sine 1.2. That means further integrate this by parts method. So it will be x square cos 2x is sine 2x on positive. Minus sign, differentiation of x square is twice x. Sign of integration into sine 2x upon 2 cancel out into dx. Again, this is by parts method that we have learned. This is x cube upon 6 minus 1.2, sorry. We write it as inside x square from 2 into sine 2x minus sign. Now this is a bypass method using again. Again bypass method. It will be minus sign that we solve it. X as it is first function. Integration of sine 2x. Okay, into dx minus sign. Gdx of x. It is in integration of gdx of x. The gdx of x integration of sine 2x. Into dx whole dx. Okay, so finally we obtain x cube upon 6 minus a half within bracket it is x square upon 2 into sine 2x minus sine within further within bracket that we change this bracket. This is this bracket. And this bracket is now let me write it. It is x into sine 2x is negative sine with minus sine cos 2x upon 2 minus sine. It will be positive here. X is 1, only cos 2x upon 2 will be there into for dx. This is dx. Bracket closed. Finally, what do we get? Let me write it here. The final answer is, let me write it here. It is x cube upon 6 minus sine 1.2 in bracket. It is positive sign, it is plus sine x cube upon 2. Sine 2x. This minus minus, if I open with this minus sign, it will be plus sign first. X upon 2 cos 2x. Okay. And then the minus sign is negative. It will be 1.2 is there. Sine 2x upon 2 integration. It is plus constant of integration. Now this minus 1.2 is to be multiplied to both of them. So this is 1.4 to 1.8. Let me write it as x cube upon 6 minus, it is 1.4 x square into sine 2x minus 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 sine. This is x upon 4 2 into 2 into cos of 2x minus minus plus here minus minus plus. This is 1.8. Okay, 1.2 and 1.8. Into sine 2x plus constant of integration. Now this x square sine 2x 1.8. Okay, if I take common, let me check. The final answer is, this is the final answer. If there is anything common, nothing. Only number can be taken common. So if I take 1.24 common, but this is 6, that is 8, 24 can be then common. That is 1.24, let me write. This is 8 into x cube. Minus sign is 4, 6, 24, 6. X square into sine 2x. Minus 4, 6, 24 again, 6. X into cos 2x. This is plus 3, 8, 3, 24. Sine 2x. Plus constant of integration. This is the final answer. This is the answer of question number 16th. Question number 16th is done. Let me talk about question number 17th now. Now question number 17th is what? Question number verse number 17, let's talk about. Now question number 17. Sign of integration, this is x into sine cube x into dx. Now we know that sine cube x is what? Since sine 3 theta is equal to 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. Minus 4 sine cube theta. Therefore, sine cube theta is equal to, okay, this 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta upon 4. This we have to substitute here. We're applying this same formula here. We can substitute sine cube x, that means x into value of this is 3 sine x minus sine 3 x upon 4 into dx. Now let me separate them. This is 1.4, 3 upon 4 first. First is 3 upon 4. 3 upon 4 into x into sine x into dx minus sine, okay, 1.4 only, 1.4 integration x into sine 3x into dx. These are the two functions. Now applying bypass method in both the cases, okay. So using bypass method, this is also product form, this is also product form, but both are different. So using bypass method in both, using BP method, in both the integrals, in both the integrands, we obtain here is 3 upon 4. Let me take 3 upon 4 common for this. X into integration of sine x dx minus sine ddx of x into integration of sine x into dx whole dx. Okay, so this is the first part. Minus 1.4 will be x into integration of sine 3x into dx minus sine ddx of x into integration of sine 3x, okay, into dx whole dx. So this is the second part. Now let us write the answer, complete answer. So it is x into sine x minus cos x. This is minus sine. Minus minus plus, it will be cos x into dx integration for integration. Minus sine 1.4. Okay, I'm sorry, this is minus 1.4, it is x into minus sine cos 3x upon 3, this value. Well, integration of sine 3x is minus cos 3x upon 3, minus cos 3x upon 3. Okay, this is the negative sign, it's minus sign. It will be positive then. Sign of integration, it is cos 3x upon 3 into dx. Now let us talk about, finally, let me write, this is minus 3 upon the first part. It is minus 3 upon 4, that's cos x, the first one, plus 3 upon 4, cos x integration is sin x. Okay, this is minus 1.4, minus plus here, it is 1.12 into x into cos 3x. This is minus sign, it is negative sign, 1.12 here, this is 1.4 and this 3, 1.12 here. Again, 3 will come out. It will be 1.3. Again, it will be sin 3x. Okay, plus constant of integration. Let me write the final answer here. The final answer of these two parts, or for bypass, using bypass method, we get this answer, which is this one, minus 3 upon 4. This is x into cos of x plus 3 by 4 sine x plus 1 pound per into S into cos of 3x minus 1.36 per 3x36 into sine of 3x plus constant of integration. Okay, now let us take something common. Anything common? Sine, sine. Okay, no, nothing. 1.36 let me take common. Then 1.36. Okay, so this is, let me write first this. But this is negative sign. It will be, well, 3 and 36. This is 3 into x into cos of 3x. This one. Minus sine, this is sine 3x. These two we have written first. Now we will add these two. It will be 4 into 4 9 36, 9 3 27, plus 27. This one sine x. Here also 27, minus 27 into x cos x. Okay, this is plus constant of integration. This is the final answer. Final answer is 1.36 into 3x into cos 3x minus sine 3x plus 27 sine x minus 27 x into cos x plus constant of integration. This is the final answer of question number 17. Okay. Question number 17 we have done. Now let me take the next question. 18th question. What did the 18th question say? Now, question number 18th. Okay. Now, question number 18th. One girl's question is, that I'll take that in the end. And we'll try. So, 18th question is, sign of integration, this is x cube into cos of qx into dx. Again, cos qx we have to apply. This is cos qx value. We know cos, since cos 3 theta is equal to 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. About this value, or 4 cos cube theta, but do this plus this. So cos 3 theta plus 3 cos theta. Therefore, cos q theta is equal to cos 3 theta plus 3 cos theta upon 4. So we can substitute this value here again. So we get sine of integration x cube into cos q means cos 3x plus 3 cos x upon 4 into ds. Again, this is of the same type. Let's take 1.4 common. Sine of integration, this is x cube into cos of 3x into ds. The first part plus sine, this is the 3 upon 4. Sine of integration, x cube into cos of x into ds. Again, the two using bypass method, using BP method. The integration of this, the integration of this, of these, let me write, will be 1.4 in the first one is common. Let me take 1.4 common. This is first function, second function, x cube as it is, integration of cos of 3x into dx minus sine ddx of x cube, ddx of x cube into integration of cos of 3x into dx whole dx plus 3 upon 4. Okay, or if I do one by one separately, let me take this is I1, this is I2. That will be better. So let me first solve the I1. Therefore, I1 is equal to, this is I1 is equal to, we are doing I1 only. Then we will do I2. We substitute these two here in this first three questions that we will answer them. First time for the first part. It will give us 1.4 into x cube. Integration of cos 3 is sine 3x upon 3 minus sine. Now this gdx is 3x squared. X cube is 3x squared. This is sine 3x upon 3 cancel out into dx. Okay, now further integrating this by parts method. So 1.3 x cube into sine of 3x minus sine. Again by parts method using this x squared into sine 3x. It is x squared as it is integration of sine 3x into dx minus sine gdx of x squared into integration of sine 3x into dx whole dx. Okay, so let me write it here. So it will give us final integration of this. Still it is to be integrated again one more time. 1.4 I1 equal to be as follows. I1, this is I1, this is I2. First integral, second integral. So this is 1.4, or in bracket it is 1.3x cubed sine of 3x minus sine, this value, this is okay, within bracket x square, integration of sine 3x is minus cos 3x upon 3 minus sine, this one, this is plus sine, minus is there, this minus cos 3x upon 3, it is twice x, and here it is twice x, okay, the 3 was answer, no problem, twice x only, into cos 3x upon 3 into dx, this value. Now x into this is to be integrated by 1, it will be 1.4, we are doing the integration of the first part only, that means first part I1, we are integrating the first part only. So this is 1.4 sine of integration 1.3 x squared into it minus, okay, it's positive sine, sine 3x, so if integration was positive, this is sine 3x, this is minus, minus, plus, let me open this with plus sine, this is 1.3 x squared into cos 3x, this minus sine, this minus sine, minus sine, okay, and 2 upon 3, let me take out, now within bracket, now this equal sign, okay, this is now to be integrated, 2 upon 3 we have taken out, x into this, x into sine of integration cos of 3x into dx minus sine vdx of x, okay, into integration of cos of 3x into dx, okay, now it will be the final value, 1.4, 1.3 into x squared sine of 3x plus 1.3 into x squared into cos of 3x minus sine 2 upon 3, it is x into cos, I'm open with minus sine as well, it will be minus 2 upon 3, cos 3x is sine 3x upon 3, sine 3x upon 3, okay, minus minus plus here, it will be x only 1, so this is sine 3x upon 3 only into dx, and 2 upon 3 is also there, 2 upon 3, okay, so then finally answer will be obtained, it will be 1.4, sine of this is 1.4, okay, this is 3 upon 4, let me substitute here, this is 1.3, x squared into sine 3x, sorry, this is sine 3x, sine 3x plus 1 upon 3 x square into cos 3x minus 2 upon 9 3 into 3 9 into x into sine 3x, which will be now with minus sign again. Integration of sine 3x is cos 3x upon 3 with negative sign. This 2 upon 3 will again come, so it will be 27 into cos 3x. Okay, so this is the final value of I1. I1 is a lengthy question, but let me write here I1. So here it will be I1, let me take here. Final I1. This was equal to I1 plus I2. I1 we have taken as, this is first question, we have taken this as the first one. I1 is this, this is I2. I1 is equal to, we have taken this, it is 1.4, okay, into, okay, 1.27. 1.4 is there. 27, 2 upon 27, if I take, then it will be 1.2 only, 54. 27 into 2 upon 27, if I take out, it will be 2 into 27 is 54. 27 into the 54. 1.54, let me take common. Final value will be this one. 9 is 18, so 18 it will be, because 18, 18 is here 54. So this is 3, 9 is, okay. In the numerator, you will get only 18 here. 3, 9 is, oh, sorry, 3 into 15, 54, that means only 18, because 3 into 3 divided by 27 is 9 into 2, 18. 18 into x square into sine 3x, okay, plus this is also the same number, this is 18 x square plus x cube, okay, x cube by x square by the, so this x square all by right. It was x square only. Okay, no problem.